It had been less than a week since the Summer Nationals, but it was already time for another race weekend. This time, I'd be heading to Amarillo, Texas, to race in the Texas Sprint Racing Series, and to coach my driver, Cadan Bell. I'd be meeting Cadan and his dad, Eben, along the way, and from there, we'd travel south to Amarillo with our carts in tow. It was the second time I'd be racing this series this year, having raced it at Speedsports back in May. Although not a national level series, it is still a strong program with a massive KA senior field with plenty of strong drivers. Now it was time for the main leg of the trip as we headed south.
Like you can tell, they have a lot of money. They got a lot of money to put into this. Alex.
After 5 hours, we arrived in a rather flat Amarillo, Texas. Our mechanic, Kevin, had flown in a few hours earlier, so he'd had some time to kill.
I had nothing else to do for 2 hours.
We decided to head to the track and get things set up and take a look at the circuit we'd be racing on.
Should be good. Helping me with my pedals.
I'm wrenching for Adam.
He's sabotaging Adam's car before this weekend.
Yeah. Caden's my mechanic this weekend.
Yeah. All right.
It's gonna be good.
Don't crash.
I mean, it's a big track. We don't need brakes anyway.
Yeah, you need them for a couple times. Unless you want to pull the Aiden Rudolph and cut turn one out, or turn two completely out.
Yeah. Sounds good to me.
I'm so surprised when you said 1080.
Film up here. Fuck.
My shoe's untied.
Come on.
Well, don't put your left wheels past the seam. Get all the way back to the right.
Just think tomorrow the two of us. Anytime you get more grip in the front, the back.
Then it was time to get things packed up and get some dinner before heading to the hotel for the night.
Adam, what the fuck's bag is this?
That is mine.
A homeless bag.
After fighting for fucking podium, that is just coming off.
I mean, you want to... 6:30?
6:30.
Today would be a practice day in preparation for qualifying at a heat race tomorrow and a heat race and final on Sunday. The engine I'd used in Newcastle the weekend prior was meant to have been shipped to the hotel, but it hadn't arrived yet, so I had to resort to a practice engine for the day.
Oh, this is bigger than Scoo's.
Oh boy, nobody likes me.
Then it was time for one of my favorite parts of any race weekend, getting on track for the first time. It was our first time on this track, so we'd start the day getting to grips with things.
I like it, you're ready, you're race ready.
I wasn't there.
Session, my pace was looking really strong as I was one of the quickest on track. Cadan had a slightly slower start, but made a lot of progress by the end of the session. This weekend I'd also be coaching Jordy Bell for the first time, a driver in the Mini Swift and 206 Cadet classes.
Right parallel, then turn. Just look how wide you are right here.
Yeah.
Look how wide you are. You should be no wider than that seam. and then you have to work so much harder to get the car back to...
As the day went on, my pace continued to look strong, and I began to get my hopes up for the potential of this weekend. Cadan also continued to get quicker and quicker with each session.
Pleasure to see you today, sir.
Hey,
absolute honor to be in your presence.
Dude, I'm glad I'm just on the, I'm making the cut for YouTube.
With the last session of the day now upon us, I aimed to have both me and Cadan end of the day on a strong note and give us some good momentum going into the rest of the weekend.
Playing with the go kart.
It's been a while since you've been in a KA, right?
About a year.
Drive fast, pronto.
While things looked good at the start of the session, things took a mysterious turn after a few laps, and I was a little confused. For Cadan, however, he had one of his strongest sessions yet, ending the session in the top 10. I was thrilled with the strong end Cadan had to his day, but we still had to push to find more speed.
So let's pay attention to your braking here.
As for my situation, we discovered after the session that my kart was not looking too good. We discovered a bow in the middle of the frame, along with it being bent side to side. As for my engine that was supposedly being delivered to the hotel, it still hadn't arrived. My practice engine had not cut it in the final session, despite shooting the carburetor on track, so I was desperate to get my race engine.
Alright.
I'll stick to my word, bro.
Man, if I still had the 1 Series, we wouldn't be talking right now.
At dinner that night, my heart sank when a message came through to say that my engine would now be delivered on Monday. This was totally unacceptable, and I had to find a way to fix this.
So I actually managed to get through to someone.
Kevin, Cadan, and I headed to the UPS center where the engine was being held. When we went inside, the people there were understanding, but told us that since the package was still in the truck, we wouldn't be able to pick it up until it was unloaded the following morning.
Get your dad know about what time, or basically what we're doing.
Okay, we'll do it.
We'll be there at like 7. See if we can get it at 7.
Great, huh?
It had been an unexpectedly stressful end to the day, but we'd be back at the UPS center bright and early the next morning to get my engine. For now, it was time to rest.
It's always something with you, bro.
Alright, don't be late. Not here yet.
I kept my fingers crossed, hoping there would be an engine for me to pick up. When we got there, we explained what the situation was and hoped for the best. We ended up waiting there for over an hour while they looked for the engine. But eventually, we managed to catch a break, and the engine was finally in our hands. The whole ordeal had made us arrive at the track late, so it was a rush to be ready for warm-up. We got things sorted in time though, and it was time to head out on track. Having endured so much to get a hold of the engine, I'd hoped for a little more than the underwhelming amount of power it gave me in warm-up. It was not an ideal start to the day.
Turn in, then it like slams down, the rear slams down. So, maybe we try cutting an end.
Yeah, so remember guys, if you are stuck on the track, it's your possibility to pick it.
Next up was qualifying, and we made some changes to try and resolve the engine issues I'd suffered in warm-up.
Now for it, definitely Davis Cunningham in that back of that little four-pack. Quick guy.
Much to my frustration, things were no better, and everything we'd done to try and improve my situation seemed to be in vain. Cadan managed to carry his momentum over from the end of Friday to have a solid qualifying. He qualified in 10th, just ahead of me in 11th.
I don't understand how I go from being 3/10 off yesterday to what was that, like a second off today in that session?
Yesterday you're
3/10
off.
That sucks.
What happened?
It was just, I had no top speed, and then through the low speed, the cart was just like bound no matter what. It was just bound up and it wouldn't get out of the corner.
I took the positives from Caden's strong qualifying, and it was time to prepare for the first heat race. After a rough day for me, I hoped that a decent first heat race could rectify things and get me back on the right track. For Cadan, he would now need to utilize his racecraft as well as pure pace to maintain his position on the edge of the top 10. My GoPro malfunctioned on the grid, leaving us only with Caden's onboard footage. Until a bit of an error undid everything.
He just like blew that corner. So
was that
bad.
Him?
Yeah, that was him.
Way back?
He just like blew that corner.
What the fuck happened there?
From there, it was an uphill fight to make up for lost ground. I crossed the line in 10th, while Caden recovered to 19th.
That would have been such a good picture, like one of those...
90%, you know what? Fuck this car.
My dad said he was watching the live stream.
What times was he running?
105.3 was his quick.
105 flat. It's faster, but like, did you see my mid-range?
Look
at that. It was so bad, it was terrible. Just missed the breaking point.
For Caden, there was a lesson to be learned, but there was still a ways to go with another heat race, and the final coming up tomorrow. For me, my engine issues had become severe enough for me to conclude that something real was wrong.
Like not knowing the outcome of what your pass was.
During the cleaning process that evening, we came to discover that a bent set of reeds were the issue, which would have had a significant effect on performance. Although unfortunate to have suffered from that all day, it improved my prospects for tomorrow. After everything was sorted, it was time to settle down for the evening. Another challenge I'd been dealing with all day was the after effects of dinner from the night before. Let's just say that something wasn't quite right with whatever it was I had at Buffalo Wild Wings the night before.
Chug it. I'll feel great tomorrow. Stock turbo?
Yeah, it's a 9 PSI stock. He turns it up to 13 and it makes 350.
The absolute best insult I've ever that Chase said. Oh, you heard it?
Just get it back up.
As usual, a critical supply run was required.
My shirt kind of goes hard, but I like Star Wars, so.
Alright.
Yo!
It better be.
That one.
No, big one.
That's it. Yep.
You get the Texas one, too.
Oh, this one's just American.
The Texas one is what you need.
With that complete, it was time for bed.
All right, we'll see, all right, see you guys in the morning. Oh my God. They just forgot about us yesterday.
Oh look, they gave us water.
It had not been the smoothest of weekends, but today would provide one more chance to set things right.
Oh,
The difference from the reads was clear to see. My pace still wasn't amazing, but it was a significant step up from Saturday.
He carries way more rolling speed.
Ready? It was time for heat race 2, and we would start in the same position as we qualified in on Saturday. Now that the engine was working better, I felt a little more hopeful than before. Positions at turn 1 and broke away with the lead pack, managing to stick with them for most of the race. Meanwhile, Cadan struggled to find the same rhythm he'd been in on Friday and Saturday, and he went backwards as a result. Frustrated Cadan crossed the line in 14th, while I finished in 8th.
We need to go back to the old
car. So slow.
I was fast.
I wasn't.
What year? The one we started. Where'd you finish?
8th. Nice. It's pretty good. I was in that lead train for a little bit.
Yeah.
With the heat races done, all that remained was the final.
I'll take those positions.
My improved day on Sunday continued when I found out I would start the final in a solid 6th place. Cadan would start in 18th.
So you're starting 18th. Yeah. 24. I'm starting 6th.
Nice!
Yeah.
That's a really good
That's not bad. Third row.
There had been a lot of adversity to push through this weekend for both me and Cadan, but now it was time to push our hardest and make our efforts count for something. I'd be looking to fight strong in the lead pack, while Cadan aimed to make up ground from a less than ideal starting spot. After all this weekend had seen, there was no giving up now. Sent off the track and launched over a massive curb on lap 1, I developed a puncture in my front right tire. Unfortunately, that was it for me, and my weekend was brought to an early end.
So he is done with a flat right front tire. So Adam Rylance into the scale line. He is done. Meanwhile, up front,
sing with him, sing for the year.
Cadan had an awesome drive through the field to just barely miss out on a top 10, a great comeback after mowing the grass on lap 1. For me, there wasn't much more to be said than it was just one of those weekends.
Back in frame table.
From weekends like this, you take whatever lessons you can and apply them to future races. I didn't let myself get too downbeat over my disappointing final, and instead directed my focus towards Cadan's solid drive. Now, it was time to pack up and prepare for the trip home on Monday morning. Instead of going home, however, I'd be spending the next few days in a vast change of scenery, from what we had here in Amarillo. I'd be meeting my parents in Ouray, Colorado for a few days before returning to my coaching duties at the Colorado Karting Tour event in Grand Junction the next weekend. With the way this weekend had gone, a few days break was definitely needed for me to be fresh for the next one.